Welcome back. Celebrated British actor Alan Rickman is back on Broadway this season in the new Teresa Rebeck play, Seminar. Rickman stars here as Leonard, a renowned writer turned tough-talking teacher who rather ruthlessly presides over a private writing class for a group of young aspiring novelists. Contributing correspondent Patrick Pacheco recently sat down to chat with Rickman about the caustic character he plays in Seminar.
How did I get off on this? What were we talking about?
Kate had a story.
All right, Kate's story. Where is it?
It's in your hand.
All right, what were we talking about?
The first sentence.
Oh, Jesus Christ. When truth is acknowledged universally, it is also universally disdained. I mean, what the f***?
That's not the whole sentence.
Yeah, I see that. I see the semicolon. I realize that means there's only a partial stop and more is coming, but I'm not sure I want to continue, okay?
Welcome, Alan, to On Stage, and congratulations on a towering performance in Seminar.
Thank you.
What makes Leonard a good, if not great, teacher?
Ultimately, he tells the truth. And ultimately, I think it's not driven by his ego, particularly. I think ultimately, the written word to him is religion.
Is that the source of the brutality, quote-unquote, the brutal, how brutal he is toward these students, or is he dealing with his own issues in that regard?
Well, his own issues are only made really clear later on in the play when you kind of get to know him on a slightly more profound level than when he's exercising his abilities as a teacher. Eventually you get to find out who he is, and so I guess like anybody, certainly of his vintage in a room full of young people, it's a cumulative thing. It's about the sum of his whole life, his successes, failures, here's who he has become, and what he believes and how he speaks is very much connected to that as much as anything else.
Did you yourself have Leonards in your life, say at RADA when you were studying acting at RADA or anywhere along your career?
Well, I certainly had truth tellers, inescapable ones. You know, the principal of RADA, Hugh Crutwell, at that time was like a god figure to us, and we would have what were called Crutwell runs of every production before they were ever put in front of the public. And he had a way of saying, in somehow managing to be encouraging at the same time, he would at the end of a performance come to one or other of us and just say, yes, but I just didn't believe a word of it. And so believing it is the great cry to me, on stage, off stage, in the rehearsal room, as a member of the audience, whatever.
In one of our previous conversations, you mentioned that the great director Peter Brook once said to you, when you were doing Antony and Cleopatra, I think, with Glenda Jackson, you'll never be as good as the text.
Yeah, not just me, fortunately. everybody in the room. When you're dealing with a great text like that, and that actually became rather comforting because you just thought, well, this horizon that we're supposed to be striving for just actually gets further and further away all the time. And so it proves in life.
In one of our previous conversations, you mentioned you can only see your limitations. Can you use that? Does that help you? Or is it something that you have to overcome when you're facing a challenging role like Leonard in Seminar?
You know, there's another great teacher, Elizabeth Percy at RADA, said very often, it's not about you. And that's true too as an actor. And with a play like this where you were just talking about the kind of visceral connection with the audience, and I'm very aware of this on a nightly basis. It's 90 minutes. It's like a roller coaster. It starts, you can feel the audience settling into their job as a member of the audience, and it is a job, you know, there's a deal going on here. We're telling you a story, and then we feed off how you receive that story. Very particularly with this play and the way Teresa writes, And you can feel that, insofar as it's measured by laughter, which it is, and silence, which it is, the two of them working together, you can feel that it's kind of polite for the first 2 or 3 minutes, and then it becomes more and more from a deeper, truer place with the audience. And that's very much to do with us listening acutely to what this exchange is between actors, a play, and an audience. And that is very much to do with it not being about me. It's about Leonard. Of course, it's my machine and our machine together. But
one of the explosive elements of the play, of course, is Leonard's seduction of the younger female students in the play. Is that a tricky terrain to occupy, or is that fun for you to play?
I'm working with four fantastic actors for a start, so it's not difficult with Etienne and Lily. It's part of life's game to him. It's part of his territory. It's for others to judge, you know. I mean, it's not, he just does it. It's just what he does.
We have to wrap up, but I wanted to ask you one last question or make an observation, and that is that Daniel Radcliffe, who considers you a mentor, told me that you had taught him that acting is a worthy profession. Did it take some time for you to arrive at that yourself? Is that an important thing to convey from one generation to another?
I think anything involved in telling stories is not just worthy, it's crucial. Otherwise, how the hell do we find out who we are unless we explain ourselves to each other via books or cinema or theatre or journalism or documentary or, you know, whatever. If we're just parading egos around or acquiring stuff and we measure ourselves by that, then we're lost, I think. And theatre is one of those mediums that can just put the brakes on from time to time and say, well, have a think about this. And how do you relate to that? I can't dictate and don't want to what any member of the audience makes of this play on any one night. I hope they have a joyful and introspective experience.
Well, you certainly managed to do that. Congratulations, and the best for a long run.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.